Well, hey guys, welcome back to another Let's Play Dwarf Fortress mode. We're pretty much where we left off with the last video. I just noticed something cool, though. I don't know, I hadn't noticed this before, but this road is U-shaped, so it goes up and down, and so it's like a perfect little roady road. I thought that was pretty cool. Anyway, I wanted to tell you some of the plans I have. They probably won't come to fruition in this video. In this video, we're setting the framework for how we're going to carry on with our fortress. But for future plans, I have some ideas for interesting things we can do with our human friends here. I happen to really enjoy pressure plate traps, and I'm quite interested in the possibility of creating like an automated human catapult and a few other fun little things for them to play with, if you will. Maybe something to launch them off here. Ah, I finally caught you. Is that a lungfish? Yes, it is. It's raining lungfish here in this town. Fantastic. Alright, so I'm gonna get back to work, and I will come back to you when I have some stuff to report. We've been kobolded! You bastard! What did you steal? He stole nothing, really. Nothing at all. Gakoris, kobold thief, from Tligilblilmus. No, I think he's going to get away with that one. But one of our animals must have spotted him. Hopefully he'll get killed by a pelleted gibbon. Oh well. We're going to have to start setting some traps, because these bastards are on to us. Ah, he stole from the humans. That's fine with me. Okay. Okay, so just a quick update. I've decided to repurpose this former apartment building as a barracks, and as such I'm having them remove all of the walls, doors, and all of the furniture and everything. I've had to unforbid it all. And I've also, I've stopped building barrels because I realized I can just have them go and steal all the barrels from out here, so I've unforbidden damn near all of the barrels. And there's another monkey. Great. I need to start capturing and training these monkeys. I want a trained army of monkeys. By the time we're done here, we will have a monkey army. So, yeah, we got a couple more areas for stockpiles here and here as backup stockpiles. And I did some other stuff, but I forgot what it was. So, yeah, mostly just wanted to let you know. Barracks next to the temple. Cool. We attracted no migrants! What's wrong with my beautiful fortress, besides the fact that I didn't build anything here, except for this trade depot, and this thing I deconstructed? Ah! Alright, back when there's more. No sign of the magma yet. I've had my farm, or my miners down here digging in sort of like an exploratory pattern, but I'm just really getting started with that. I'm building another stockpile over here to expand that, and things are going very well with food and drink stores. We've got lots of food and lots of drinks, and our farms are producing quite well. It's been raining, that's good, and we're almost done clearing out a path for our trade depot here. So we just gotta clear out the rest of these trees, and then they will have... Uh-oh. They should be able to get up this road. I may need to widen it, but for now, that'll be fine. What the hell? What happened here? A mandrill! And Q2 is going to go steal something from the humans, which I will enjoy watching. Wow, there was a mandrill attack, and I didn't even know about it. See, these humans, they're willing to die to defend us while we steal from them. And these monkeys are very, very cautiously hiding. Damn, look at all these mandrills. Good job, person. Alright, more to come. Our food stores have just miraculously gone up to about 400. Look at all that meat. Where could all that meat have come from? Why, it came from the humans. I just took a look at all these barrels, and they're filled with meat. Apparently, awesome meat. Like, there's some elephant meat here, which is cool. It was all forbidden, so I'm going through and I'm slowly unforbidding all of these barrels and their contents, because I want bonobo meat. This is a great place to have a fort, I tell you. Not often I get a fort that comes with its own stocks of elephant meat. So yeah, I don't think we're going to need to be worrying about food for a while. We're pretty much set. We just got to do the brewing. Alright. Ah, autumn has arisen on the calendar. Time to reset the farms and There's a monkey standing outside of my house. There's a lot of monkeys. We're surrounded by monkeys. They're bonobos. They've come for their meats. Oh yeah, I took the advice of Mookie Moogie and the Lunatic, and I plugged the hole here with a rough basalt block floor. However, I did manage to, I don't have another floor hatch. I connected these guys, their apartment building here, down here into the dining room up here, and also to the rest of the fortress over here. So they've got their little rooms connected, and I need to build another hatch there for them to use. We've got plenty of furniture now, lots and lots of weapons and food and drinks and all sorts of stuff, and we just need to figure out what to do about this bonobo problem. We've been surrounded by monkeys. Oh yeah, I've got our guys out here dealing with the rest of these trees and these stones. I've been smoothing out the boulders and stuff so that here they have a nice clean pathway to get to the trade depot if they ever decide to come. which would be nice of them, because I've got all kinds of cool stuff to trade. But, hey, what are you doing, Doskoot? Oh, he needs to get his farm on. He needs to be told again. Alright, so, that's enough for this update, and I'll check and see how much time we have left, and carry on from... Oh my god, puppies! Puppies! Yay! Where's my little puppy machine? Are you the one? Oh, puppies! It's just two puppies, a boy and a girl puppy. Aww, puppies! Okay, I'm done. A stray cat has given birth to kittens. Oh, and the outpost liaison has arrived. And a caravan has arrived. Awesome! Okay, but, I just wanted to point out, a stray cat has given birth to kittens. All of them inside of a cage. So suck it down, guy who told me that wouldn't happen. Yeah, I'm right. You're wrong. Woo! Alright, anyway, we've got a trade caravan here. Let me take a look at you, buddy. Okay, Alex, you are the trade man, so you need to stop doing all that other stuff. And we need to get you to go and trade with the dude. Trading with the dude. Where's our thingy? Okay. Trader needed at the depot. Wait, he's gonna have to meet with the liaison, too. What are you guys doing? Oh, they can't get from where they came from. Those idiots. Well, maybe they can. Why did they come from there? There's a fucking road down here. Oh, wow, they're agile farm wagon things. How do I... There we go. Let's see here. Well, I don't feel like robbing them at this point. It's not really worth it to me. I don't have enough dwarves to do the hauling jobs for all that. But I am going to tell all my guys to... Aw, there he is. He's going to meet with Alex, who is still storing items in the stockpile. Hurry up, finish. You've got stuff to do. I'm going to turn off the trader needed at the depot for now, so that he can go meet with the liaison. Dig. No. Not even that. It can wait. Oh, what are you doing? Ah, alright. Anyway, I'll get this figured out and then I'll be back. Aha! Here we go. I am your liaison from the Mountain Homes. Let's discuss your situation. Let us discuss it. They're discussing it next to my kitten. Aha! Okay, what do we request of their merchants? We need cloth. How do I... No, I want to... There we go. Cloth. Put that one there. We need metal bars. Preferably cheap ones. Aluminum. And let's get some small gems. Cut gems. Seeds. Any kind of seeds you got. That ought to be enough for now. I'm not really worried about the rest of the stuff, so I'll leave that for now. Alright, and so this one's going to be coming to an end, and Alex is going to go eat and ignore the liaison, but hopefully in the next one I'll get to trade with these traders and do some business, and hopefully they can tell me what they want from me. Alright, so thanks for watching this. Daskud is a planter now. This Let's Play Dwarf Fortress mode, and I will see you in the next one.